हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू भूविज्ञान मॉड्यूल्स। एंड टुडे इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द मॉड्यूल फिफ्थ ऑफ आवर फिजिकल मिनरोलॉजी, दैट इज एम्फीबोल ग्रुप। सो देयर आर लॉट ऑफ मॉड्यूल्स आर अवेलेबल टॉपिक वाइज, सो यू कैन परचेज दिस मॉड्यूल्स फ्रॉम द वेबसाइट। इन देयर सब टॉपिक्स आर ऑल्सो देयर। सी हियर इन लॉट ऑफ प्रैक्टिस क्वेश्चन यू विल गेट, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन ओर जियोलॉजी यू कैन सी। सो इट विल रियली एनहेंस योर नॉलेज एंड इट विल रियली हेल्प यू in your exam. So let's discuss the amphibole group today. So the first question is the basic structural unit of amphibole is. So we know that the SI to O ratio in case of amphibole is what? 4 is to 11. This we know that, isn't it? And so as per the option, so this one will be option because it has minus 6 of valency. Amphibole has minus 6 of valency. So the exact answer for this question is this one. So this was a pretty easy question. And amphibole also belong to your double chain silicate. This is also important to note. There is no double chain silicate. Okay. So in the double chain silicate, the Si2O ratio is 4 is to 11. And for bridging to non-bridging, I have given one question in Telegram group. I have provided a solution also for that. So those who have not seen that particular solution, you can see in the Telegram group. So in that, I have given the bridging to non-bridging ratio of the oxygen in case of amphibole. So let's move to the next question now. So let's see the next question. Yeah, so I have given the solution also here. So the next question here is, the complex composition of member of an amphibole group is given by this formula. So this is the formula we have, general formula for amphibole. Okay, here this A represent what? It represent A site. Here bigger ion, the ion which is having the larger radius size will occupy this space. The second here B is known as M4 site, means the ion which is comparatively smaller than the ion of the A size. C here is a octahedral site, and T here is tetrahedral site. Okay, so as per this we will see the option here in this given question. So let's see the options. So herein we can see that our this option number B, okay, this Na and K will occupy the A4 site because their size is comparatively small, and Na can also occupy your M4 site also. This you should know. Okay, Na can occupy M4 site also. But K cannot occupy your M4 site because its size is very large. So this is the main thing here. And one more thing, Mg can occupy M4 site as well as your octahedral site. So Mg can occupy your M4 site. We will see this in one question, maybe in next question, that Mg can occupy both M4 site and octahedral site. So, and we know that silicon will occupy your tetrahedral site, and this aluminium is also very important because aluminium can occupy both your octahedral and tetrahedral site, and silicon will always occupy your tetrahedral site. So these are the few important things here you should have to know about this thing. So let's see. Yeah, so I have given the solution also for this question. You can look into it, that nearly complete substitution take place between the sodium. So you can read, okay, if you purchase the module, you will easily get access to all the solution, all those things. So let's move to the next question. Yeah, so I was discussing about this question only in my just before question. I told you na, how Mg can occupy both your M4 site and octahedral site. So let's read this question. Where is the highlighter? This is a razor. Okay, no highlighter is available in this software. Okay. So in case of your anthophyllite, MgXSI, so formula is given to us as MgXSI8, O22 and OH twice. And here it is said that Mg occupies both M4 and octahedral site. So we have seen that in case of when Mg is occupying your M4 site, so it will be what? Mg2? In just in the previous question, general formula of our amphipole was there. No? A was 0 to 1 and B was octahedral site was your 5. And sorry, this was A site and this was octahedral site. And the C, this was A site, this was M4 site, then we have here octahedral site, this is B2, no, this is C5, and then we have tetrahedral site, that is T8, then we have OH, twice, something like this was there. So, in case of octahedral site, we can clearly see that we need 5 molecules here. We can see we need a 5 molecules here. Okay. So, here Mg is occupying both M4 site and tetrahedral site. So, when it is occupying your, when Mg, let me use the highlighter. So, Mg is occupying both your octahedral site and M4 site here. So, how many Mg will come? And here in place of X, I can rearrange this formula. It will become Mg2 in place of M4 site, then Mg5 in place of octahedral site, and then I can write this formula again. Okay. So now in case of ferroactinolite, here the formula is given as this one. Let me write that formula too. So it is given as Ca2F. EpSi8O22 and OH twice. Here Fe is occupying your octahedral site. So in case of octahedral site, we have 5 here. So here the value of P will come to be 5. Now the absolute difference between the X and P is asked. So what is the value of X here? How many Mg is there? 5 plus 2, 7. So value of X is 7 and value of P is 5. So the absolute difference between 7 minus 5 is how much? It is 2. So I think this is clear. So 2 is the answer of this particular problem. Okay. Yeah, 2. Oh. 2. So 3 marker is selected. So let's move to the next question now. So 2 is the answer of this one. Yeah, so I have given the solution here also. Okay, so you can take a screen, take a note of this one. And one more thing is that if you purchase the module, you can log in it with only 2 devices, and if you take a screenshot, then there will be a, you won't be accessed to the module for, you say, like 14 or 15 days, I think so. Okay. So, but you can see the level of questions are so good, no? You can, it will really help you in your competitive exams. So, let's move to the next question now. Yeah, so this one is a pretty easy one. So, all the amphiboles except anthophyllite are what? So all the amphiboles except anthophyllite are monoclinic in nature. Okay, so this is one of the theoretical question. I put theoretical question also. So let's do this. Because in each and every module, there will be 60, 70 numerical type question, and 30, 40 you will get a theoretical problem only. So the next question is the absolute difference between the cleavage in case of amphibole when looking from the C-axis is how many degrees? So we have to find the absolute difference, that is 124 is the maximum degree and 56, I think. Yeah, so somewhere near around this. So difference, if you do of this, you will get answer around 68. Okay. So 68 is the answer of this one. Let's see. I have given the solution also. Yeah, so 124, you can see here all the amphibole except ventrophile are monoclinic in nature and show the excellent prismatic cleavage of 110 family. And the angle between the cleavage is however 56 to 124. So I have asked you the difference between these two values. Okay, absolute difference between these two values. So 56, 124 minus 56. So you can see here the cleavage in case of amphibole is 126 and 56. And another important thing is it belong to the family of 110. Okay. So and we are looking this along the our c-axis. So I think this question is also clear. So let's move to the next question now. Yeah, so one more theoretical question. So which among the following type of amphibole occur almost exclusively in low grade metamorphism? So here key term is, what is the key term here? It's a low grade metamorphic rock. Okay, and particularly with high CA concentration. So high CA concentration and especially occur in metadolomites and ultra basic rocks. So high CA concentration, we know which type of amphibole it is. It is a tremolite. Okay. And tremolite is a low grade metamorphic rock, generally occur with metadolomites and all those. So this is also done. Let's move to the next question now. I have given the theory also here, so you can read about all those things. And tremolite is an indicator of metamorphic grade. At high grade it converts to diopside. So this is very important that tremolite at high grade get converted into diopside. Okay, so this point you can note down that tremolite is an indicator of metamorphic grade, low metamorphic grade. Okay, I forgot to write here low metamorphic grade, and when the temperature increases it convert into a diopside. So this question is also done. So let's move to the next question. So this is very 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 easy question. I give one or two easy question every time because to give the motivation to the student. So this is very easy question, almost a JM BSc student can also solve it. So this is a common mineral in a blue cyst species. We know that which is the common type of amphibole in blue cyst. It's a glaucophyte. Okay, and that result from low temperature high pressure metamorphic along the ancient subduction zone. So this was one of the famous question, and it was asked 2-3 times in GATE and in JAM, and mostly I think this is one of the most common question we will see in most of the geology exams. So one easy question I can put. Okay, so this is how you know you understand easy question, tough question. How tough question will come? No, so let's now solve the tough questions. So let's read the question first. Let me use a highlighter. So this in the general formula of amphibole, in this one we have looking this from our starting, that this is our general formula of amphibole, where A, B, C, T are cationic side with different coordination numbers. So A has this much coordination number, B is the different coordination numbers are given here. Okay, so the amount of octahedral aluminium in amphibole of composition this one is how much? Okay, so let's solve this one. This question appeared in JAM, so it's not like that the level of JAM is easy. It's not like that the level of JAM is also quite good. So the formula is given to us is A 0 to 1, which is what? A4 site, and B2, which is our amphocyte, C5, that is our octahedral site, T8, O22, OH twice. This is the general formula for amphibole. Okay, general formula for amphibole. Now the given formula is this one. So let's write the given formula also. The given formula is Na 0.6 Ca2 Mg 3.8 aluminium 3 silica 6.2 and O22 and OH twice is given to us. So here you can see here that silica is having only 6.2 number of molecules. Okay, so it should have 8. No, means not silica should have 8, that our tetrahedral position should have 8 here. You can see here that it should have 8. Okay, so we know that as in the first question, I first or second question I told you that aluminium can occupy both your tetrahedral as well as octahedral side. Okay, this aluminium can go into both tetrahedral and octahedral side. So here silicon is 6.2, okay, and here three aluminium is there. So these three aluminium will transfer its some amount of what you say to make it 8. We have to make the tetrahedral position as 8. So 8 minus 6.2, if we do, what we get? We get 1.8. So this, out of this 3 aluminium, 1.8 aluminium will go to here to satisfy our tetrahedral side. Okay, so if 1.8 went there, so how much aluminium is left in the octahedral position? Out of 3, 1.8 went to tetrahedral position. Tetrahedral. So in octahedral position, because this is our octahedral position, so how many aluminium will remain in here? Here aluminium will remain 3 minus 1.8, that is 1.2. And here aluminium will come out to be 1.2. And you can see here 1.2 plus 3.8 is 5. So in octahedral side we have 5 here. Okay. So I think I have answered this question very well. And if you have doubt, let's see the next question, then it will be much more clear to you. So answer come out to be 1.2. So this type of question generally asked, okay, in the exams or even the solution also. Let's see. This question is also based on our previous concept only. So this is a general formula of an amphibole. So the equation of glycophane is given as this one. So let's write the equation of glycophane. Na2 Mg4 Al2 Si7 O22 OH twice. So you can see here that here in case of tetrahedral only seven is there. Okay, and we know that how much should be there? 8 should be there. You can see here 8. So as I told you, aluminium can occupy both the sides. So one aluminium will go there. Okay, one aluminium will go there. So now how many aluminium are left? If one went there, it was two there, so only one aluminium are left to be in the octahedral side. So it is asked that the amount of aluminium in the octahedral side is asked. So one will be there, and in octahedral side five should be there. So this is Mg4 and one aluminium, so it will be five. Okay, so one is the answer of this one, isn't it? Now it is becoming easy. You see how means same type of question I built so that your concept will get, you know, much more evolved from how you can tackle the problem. Because listen, everyone studies geology in this field, but the questions are very less, you know. You don't get any practice questions. So you see the question directly in exam, so you are not able to solve the simple questions also. So therefore, I module is a kind of ebook where you can practice a lot of problems, you can study, and this will give you much more confidence. So one I got, let's see. Next question now. So I have given the solution also. Yeah, so this is our last question. Okay, so let's discuss this question too. So the Hornblende equation is given by this one. So let's write this one. It's CaNa from 2 to 3, then MgP Fe2 Al2 0.2. Al is 2.2. Okay, I also got confused. Al 2.2, here bracket is there, and x here, and Si6 SiAl2, and this thing is there, O22 OHF plus. So the amount of magnesium in the octahedral side is asked. So we it is asked that how much magnesium are there here in this place, no? This, how much magnesium is there? This one, P, the value of P we have to calculate. Okay, the value of p we have to calculate. So how we will do it? We know that in case of our octahedral position, here 5 should be there as per the general equation. So we know that the value of x is what? We know that the value of x is 5. So this x value will come out to be 5. Any doubt in this one? Because from the previous question also we are seeing in octahedral position, as per the formula, 5 should be there. So value of x we got as 5. Now this question become very easy, because this all should be equal to 5. So we get what? P plus 2 plus 2.2 is equal to 5. So this will become P is equal to 4.2 is equal to 5. So value of P will come out to be 5 minus 4.2, that is equal to 0.8. So 0.8 is the answer of this question. We have to give the answer in only one decimal place. So 0.8 is the answer of this question. So I hope this, I have given a solution also. So I hope this module on FEBO group help you. So you see how you much confidence you get after solving this module, that you understand FEBO group in very much detail. Now in pyroxene group also question are like this only. Olivine group also we have, and the further module will come on feldspar, plagioclase, feldspar. In feldspar only I will include the plagioclase, feldspar. Mica and clay will include, and certain other groups also will include. Then this will end our modules of the physical mineralogy. Thank you very much for watching this video. All the best for your exam.